Lumbar spine X-rays are one of the most commonly requested radiography investigations of the spine. However, it should be noted that projectional radiography has limitations and other imaging modalities such as MRI and CT should be considered if further evaluation is required. But not all the hospitals have MRI and CT, so you must know how to properly read a lumbar X-ray and define pathologies even in the earliest stage or rule out others. Hi, I am Dr. Ben, senior radiologist, and today's tutorial is about how to read a lumbosacral X-ray. Let's begin. Lumbosacral X-ray interpretation is a key competence for medical students and junior doctors. It is fundamental to be familiar with the normal anatomy expected for each radiographic projection. Being used to what is normal allows one to identify what is not and most likely a finding. Now, take in consideration these key points. First one, plain a radiograph provides information about bone, joint, and soft tissue structures. You have to be systematic and serially compare. You have to look at all views available and, if possible, compare with all images. And always believe you have missed a finding. This is very important. Assess image quality and, if clinically appropriate, consider requesting a repeat X-ray. The lumbar spine series is comprised of two standard projections along with a range of additional projections depending on clinical indications. A standard projection, PA or AP view, lateral view, and others like oblique views and functional views. Today, our main focus should be in the AP and lateral views, which are the most common use everywhere. You have to take in consideration the technique of the X-ray. First, the entire lumbar spine should be visible, with demonstration of T11, T12 superiorly and the sacral inferiorly. No patient rotation. As evident, you can use central spinous processes and the symmetrical appearance of the sacroiliac joints and iliac wings. You have to look at the intervertebral joints, and also you need to have an adequate image penetration and image contrast. We evident by clear visualization of lumbar vertebral bodies, pedicles, and face joints, with both trabecular and cortical bones demonstrated. Now, for the AP view, the provider should be able to see the L1 to L5 and T12 vertebral body, T11, T12 space, and the sacrum. For the lateral view, the vertebral bodies, transverse processes, face joints, and pedicles should be clearly seen. Now, let's move to the views. Let's talk about the AP view. This is the best view to determine if there is curvature in the spine and may also help identify any metastasis. Evaluate for proper spinous process and vertebral body alignment. When viewing the curvature, be aware that the curvature in the thoracic spine may be exist when viewing the lumbar spine and rib curve. Most adolescent scoliosis is level scoliosis or convex left. Now, in case of the lateral view, this is the best projection for showing loss of disc space, degenerative changes, or subluxation. One should first check for alignment of the vertebral bodies and each vertebral body, disc space, posterior elements, and transverse processes. These spaces should gradually increase height from superior to inferior in the lumbar spine, with the exception for the L5-S1 space, which sometimes being less than L4-L5. The pedicles gradually become wider from superior to inferior. So I brought to you this checklist. Hopefully it should be very helpful for you. First, check the position. You have to check for lumbar lordosis, normal bed, and normal vertebral alignment. You have to check the number of vertebrae. You have to check the
vertebrae shape, scallop, rectangle. You have to check for structures like mineralization and normal trabeculation, no patchy or linear densities or no lucencies. You have to check the contour for the vertebra like a cortex, including the end place. It's smooth and sharp, no contour defect, no sclerosis, no vagina osteophyte. You have to check the pedicles to be elliptical, paired, and symmetrical. And the processes, spinal processes, shape, you have to be shaped, smooth, and intact contours, and contact between adjacent processes. You have to check the transverse processes. You have to check the shape, the contour, and the effect, and the articular processes, which is very important to check all these kind of things. And also, you have to check the disc space, which will be a normal height, no vacuum phenomenon, no disc calcifications. And the last is soft tissue, no foreign bodies or calcifications. There is child drainage of psoas margins. Now, very important data. Lumbosacral angle should be between 26 to 57 degrees with 34 in average. The shape, height, and width from L1 to L3 is around 0.87 centimeters with 1 centimeter in women. You have to know very clearly about the height of this space between L1 to L5 and the width of the spinal canal, 0.6 centimeters. And in the sagittal view, the diameter is greater than 1 centimeter. Or you have to divide both diameters, and there should be more than 0.5 centimeters. It's less than that, should be suspicious for a spinal stenosis. Now you have a clear view about how to read a lumbosacral, so you can read and look for early signs of difficult diseases to diagnose at the in early stage. So let's look at it first. Let's start with the tuberculosis spine. So early sign of tuberculosis radiograph, maybe they are to be maybe normal in the early stage of the disease, but you have to take in consideration changes that are often present at the time of the initial study, as occurring around 70 in a lot of cases, some studies say. A reduction in vertebral height is often seen with the regularity of the anterior superior end plate, being a relative early and subtle sign. This is a classical appearance with TV spondylosis. Accurate interpretation of images require experience and understanding of spinal anatomy. But now you can see in this X-ray how you can demonstrate it, demonstrate these early changes. So when you are sitting in your consulting room and you receive this young lady or adult with this back pain, you should be able to think in this kind of disease, this in this area of Africa, sub-Saharan, you have to think in both disease. And then knowing the anatomy and what we teach you today, you can go and look for these small changes on the spine and find the early stage of this terrible disease and help to save a life for sure. Now, let's go to talk about metastasis. For early sign of lumbar metastasis, you have to check the pedicles. So metastasis have a predilection for involving the posterior vertebral body and pedicle. So you are going to see a missing pedicle or absent pedicle sign, also called the winking wall sign. It's a useful and subtle sign to seek on it. Now, every time you are looking for the pathology, you are able to recognize or diagnose this terrible disease, which you cannot miss out because they affect the quality of the life of the patients. So far, this is the end of this short tutorial. I hope from today's on, you have a proper point of view when you are reading a lumbar X-ray. So, see you then.